in 50 years or so of doing this, it's never been this frustrating. It's crazy. It's going to get worse. If you want something, you're going to have to pay more for it. There's just not going to be enough to go around.
Trucking operator Tom Heimgartner claims what you want for the holidays could be piled up somewhere inside a cargo container, possibly at ports Newark and Elizabeth, as trucks sometimes wait twice as long to access terminals and unloaded containers clog distribution centers. Months-long bottlenecks in both shipping and truck traffic at ports in California and along the eastern seaboard have throttled transportation so badly.
Merchandise that isn't in distribution centers now or within the next month or so is not going to be available to purchase for the Christmas season.
Nike reportedly can't find enough shipping containers to deliver its products from overseas. Costco is limiting purchases on items like toilet paper, and toy companies are telling consumers to do their holiday gift buying now.
We are short on containers, we're short on labor at the ports, we're short on truckers to be able to even move things out of the ports. So all of that adds to a headache.
Supply chain expert Arash Azadegan explained it's a worst-case scenario. Since the pandemic, there's a worker shortage nationwide. With consumer demand spiking, container ships often queue up 60 deep and more, waiting to offload at terminals in L.A. Ships don't wait as long to dock at ports here in New York and New Jersey, according to the Port Authority.
I've not really characterize the ship side of the supply chain as problematic, or even at the terminal, although the terminals are in fact operating at very high utilization. It's that entire flow to the warehouse, distribution facilities, and then obviously where the cargo goes after that. There are bottlenecks throughout that system.
There's a lot of finger pointing. The terminals tell us we need to get more stuff off the terminal so they can operate more efficiently. And we tell them, you need to get our trucks in and out faster so we can pick up more loads.
Heimgartner notes productivity's down 40%. Despite a container shortage, mountains of empty boxes take up valuable space at the port because it's cheaper than returning them. And costs keep rising. Shipping rates from Asia soared 7 to 10 times higher since COVID, and that directly impacts product availability, according to shipping expert Karthi Puranam.
Most of our consumables, they come from outside the country. And shipping from Asia has been really bad. The reliability for trans-Pacific ships has been very low, and it has been at all-time lows, even at the New York, New Jersey ports.
Because the cost of shipping is so high, some manufacturers and some parts providers are refusing to make stuff. Right? So it just doesn't make sense for them business-wise to do that.
In fact, Heimgartner says truckers make better pay working so-called last-mile deliveries for Amazon than waiting in line at the port. It's all adding up to a rocky shopping season.
If it's on a ship, it's delayed, it's going to be expensive. That's the bottom line there.
I'm Brenda Flanagan, NJ Spotlight News.